Very good day to all of you students. Today I shall teach you class 10th political science lesson 4 and name of the chapter is gender, religion and caste. So in this chapter our first point is gender division. So student, as you know, gender division, it existed in our society, and student, it is a form of hierarchical social division. And it is considered as natural and it is unchangeable. Student, it is based not on the biology, but it is based on the social expectations also. So student, as you know, in gender division, there are male and females are there. So there is a common belief that the main responsibility of the woman is to do household work, to handle the family, to bring up the children, to do the cleaning work, to do the cooking work. So it is the responsibility of woman. And the responsibility of the man is to do job, to earn money for the family. So it is a belief that the woman will do household work and the man will go outside to earn the money. But sometime what happened? That the women, they handle house also and they do outside work also, they earn money also. So, but the men, they don't do household work. But if there is a cooking work in the hotels or outside, and if it is a paid job, then the men are also involved in this work. So student, women, they do domestic work also, and they do they go in the offices also. And some poor women, they work in the houses of the middle class family also to earn some income. So student, as you know, the role of the woman in the public life, that is a minimal role of the woman in public life is minimal. So due to this, what happened? So there were agitations and women started feminist movements so that they could get political and legal status of women. But student, what happened? Due to the movements, due to the agitation by the women, so now there is an improvement in their educational and career opportunities, and they are now working as a scientist, as a doctor, as an engineers or managers, college, university teachers. So student, in Scandinavian countries, such as Sweden, Norway, Finland, so the participation of women in public life is very high. Student, our next point is women's discrimination. So women are discriminated in society in different aspects of life. So student, our first point in the discrimination is education. Women are deprived of an equal access to education. So equal education is not given to women. Thus the literacy rate among the women is only 54% as compared to 76% among men. Or student, as you know, a small proportion of girl students go for the higher education. Only small proportion of girls go for the higher education, and after that they drop out as their parents, they don't want to spend money on the girls. They want to spend money only on the boys. So there is a discrimination on education between the boys and girls. And next discrimination is, student, discrimination in job opportunities. And there is a discrimination in salary. The number of women on highly paid job is less than men. The number of women on highly paid jobs, these are less than men. Women are discriminated in job opportunities and they are discriminated for the highly paid and for the valued jobs. And student, under Equal Wages Act, there is an act under Equal Wages Act, equal wages should be paid for the equal work. Act is there, Equal Wages Act is there, but the women are not paid as equal to men, and the women are paid less salary than men. So even the women work more than the men, even then they are paid less. And next, student, preference for the son. So parents prefer to have sons rather than girl. And there are cases, student, where the girl child is aborted before she is born. So sex ratio has declined from 927 in 2001 to 850 or 800 in some places. And student, there are other cases of the discrimination of women. There are cases of harassment, exploitation, violence. So student, women are exploited by their employers and they are sexually assaulted at homes. They are not safe during their journey at night, and they are subjected to various forms of domestic violence such as beating and harassment. Yes, student, our next point is need for woman empowerment. There is a necessity for the woman empowerment. Student, as you know, in democracy, so there is a lack of representative of women. Women are not leader. There is a lack of, often we have seen that men are leader only. So student, the number of women in the electoral body is very low in comparison to men. So student, as you know, men do not pay adequate attention to the women's problem. So men are unable to understand the problem of women. So there is a need that our leader should be woman, so that the woman can understand the problem of the woman and women can take decision for the benefit of the woman. So student, in India at present, the representation of women as elected representative in the legislature is very low, and the percentage of elected women member in the Lok Sabha and in the Rajya Sabha has been less than 10%. So women in the as a member in the Lok Sabha or in the state assembly has been less than 10%. It is only 5%. And student, the percentage of women in our national parliament is 8.3 against the 40 in the Nordic countries, and the world average 16.8. So student, there is a need for more representation of women as elected representative. So in this way, women will be empowered and other problems will be solved. So student, this is a first part of this chapter, and rest of the things I shall tell you in the next video. And I think you might have understood this, you like it, you share it to the students to get education. So student, thank you. Have a nice day. God bless you all.